Would you like to learn better by following this course step by step? Well, then watch carefully this multi-currency feature course setup. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. You only need very basic knowledge of QuickBooks Online to enjoy this course and learn well. You should have some small experience entering QuickBooks Online transactions. Doing the basic setup on your own will remind you of the minimum you need to know to be able to do this course. So, after you create a separate QuickBooks Online account specifically for this course, all you have to do is add these six accounts to the chart of accounts that you already have. Some accounts might already be there, but make sure that the detail type is the same as you see here. These are the three customers that you should put in to set up your QuickBooks Online account to be able to match numbers for this course. You don't have to put in anything but their name because their address and their other information will not be relevant for the course. Here are the list of vendors that you should input to set up your QuickBooks Online account for this course. And again, you don't have to put their addresses, you just have to put their names. Now, these are the two items on the list of products and services that you have to put in order to set up your QuickBooks Online account for the course. And when you create these items, you should attach these items to the income accounts with the same name. You see, this way, you'll know which accounts to connect them to, and you'll be able to do the setup transactions. Now, I think it's important to start the course having already had some numbers and some transactions in the QuickBooks Online account. Because if you are activating the multi-currency feature in QuickBooks Online, you probably already have a good number of transactions with the US dollar. So if you could pause the video and record these 13 transactions, it will accomplish two things. It will set the stage for a more realistic experience using the QuickBooks Online multi-currency feature, and it will also help remind you of the basic type of transactions that you need to know how to enter in order to be able to do this course. So take your time and record these 13 transactions, and if you recorded all of them properly, you should finish with this trial balance. And this trial balance will be the starting numbers in the very next video when we start recording transactions with multi-currency. Actually, the two videos that follow this one are additional setup videos, and then there are two videos that show you how you might be able to get your other QuickBooks Online account for free. I cannot promise that you will get the QuickBooks Online account for free, but at least watch the videos and try. And if you don't get a free QuickBooks Online account, you can still learn by watching the videos and applying it to your situation. I thank you very much, and I will see you in the next video.